In undersampling, we are basically losing out on important information. How do we tackle that? We tackle that by using something called as oversampling. In oversampling, we kind of increase the number of samples in the minority class to match up to the number of samples in the majority class. In the previous videos, we've looked at undersampling methods. This video will help you get an idea of how oversampling is done. The basic fundamental idea of oversampling is you take the minority class and try to create new samples that could match up to the length of my majority class samples. What I mean by that is, if you have 100 samples in your minority class and 10,000 samples in your majority class, then you should increase your minority class sample from 100 to say 9,000 or 10,000, so that the length of both your majority and minority class add up. That's the bare minimum idea of how oversampling is achieved. There are various ways of doing it. One of them is random oversampling, and the other is SMOTE, wherein you create artificial samples of your minority class. We'll first look at random oversampling. So the way random oversampling works is, you have your minority class and you have 100 samples, and you have your majority class and you have 1000 samples. You will pick a row randomly from this minority class and put it into the data set. So I'll first pick up, say, row number 99, put it up here again, and I'll do this iteratively so that I match the total number of points which are there in my majority class. That is how random oversampling works. Now in comes the next method, which is called as SMOTE. So the full form of SMOTE is synthetic minority oversampling technique. Say, for example, you have two features, x1 and x2. We have more number of black samples as compared to blue samples. So there is class imbalance that is there. Now, rather than decreasing the black samples, I'll be increasing the blue samples, which is my minority class samples, by using SMOTE. How does this work is what I'll explain. So I'll magnify the minority class samples in the next sheet. So I had 4 points in my minority class. So I had P1, P2, P3 and P4. And now if I do SMOTE analysis on this, which is my minority class, if I specify the k nearest neighbors that I want to consider to create artificial samples as, say, 3, or rather than going into the depth, how SMOTE works is it will find out the nearest neighbors of every point. So for P1, you have P2, which is your nearest neighbor, P3 is your nearest neighbor, and if you keep a nearest neighbor count of 3, then even P4 is your nearest neighbor. Similarly for P3, P1 is nearest neighbor, P2 is nearest neighbor, and P4 is nearest neighbor. For P4, you have P2, P1 and P3. Based on the number of samples you want SMOTE to create, SMOTE would first find out these lines, which is the line joining your minority class samples based on how many nearest neighbors you've considered, and it will plot these instances somewhere on these lines. So I'll have one minority point new here, which is artificially generated, I'll have one point here, which is artificially generated. I can have one point here. I can have one point here. I can have one point here, and I can have one point here. If I've kept a count of more number of samples between each link that I create, I can have multiple samples on one single link as well. So it all depends on what you configure and how many data points you want. After synthesizing the new minority instances, the imbalance that existed in our data set would go down considerably. Now, if you go back to the same diagram that we had, we created good amount of samples again using SMOTE. So one was here, one was here, one was here. I had a sample here, I had a sample here, and I had a sample here again. Now, this ratio is almost 50-50. You have equal number of blue samples and equal number of black samples. So you can specify how many artificial samples you want to grow in SMOTE so as to match up with your majority class. Let's now write code for implementing SMOTE using Python. Now that we're clear on the concept of how SMOTE works, let's now write code for implementing SMOTE for oversampling. We are still referring to the same data set where I had some features and a target variable. I split that features into xtrain, xtest, ytrain and ytest. In my ytrain itself, I have close to 190,000 samples of class 0 and around 343 samples of class 1. So there is a clear imbalance that is there in my data set. Now the task in hand is to perform oversampling, for which we are using SMOTE. In order to use SMOTE, I'll first import SMOTE and assign it to a variable called as SM. Once we have done that, we'll also have to pass in some parameters. I pass in random state and ratio, wherein I assign ratio to be equal to 1. The significance of assigning ratio to be equal to 1 is it equates or it creates samples so that my minority class samples are equal to the majority class samples. So in our example, I have close to 190,000 samples for class 0. After using SMOTE, I'll have 190,000 samples in class 1 as well. So I basically fit the samples that are there in hand, and let's see what SMOTE gives me. So as it was evident by the ratio that we chose, we'll have the same number of samples for class 0 as well as class 1. Now let's go ahead and fit our logistic regression model and see the results. So I have ytest predicted as well. Now once I look at the confusion matrix, as you can see, there are good amount of false positives in the system, which is what I don't want in my setup. So is there a way to tackle it? Yes, which we'll talk in some time. But that's how you kind of do SMOTE at the topmost level. Now if I generate the model report as well, I see that it's a fairly accurate model but with a very low F1 score. And the AUC values are also very high. Now that we've understood that how SMOTE works and how it's implemented in sklearn, we had this issue of false positives into the system. Or to create a balance between false positives and false negatives, what we have done in previous videos is what we'll do again. We'll do good amount of hyperparameter tuning. Rather than me having to decide the optimum weight or ratio for SMOTE, it's better that I fit models based on those ratios and see which gives me better results. One thing that I would like to mention is the right way of doing SMOTE is not applying SMOTE directly on your training data as it is. What I mean by that is, once you split your data into train and test, that is a good way of applying SMOTE only on your training data. So if you apply SMOTE directly on your data without splitting it, you are essentially creating new samples that would appear in your validation or your testing set as well, which would give out misleading results. So all your artificial samples should only be used for training and not for testing purposes. Whatever you apply SMOTE on is only going to be used in training, and don't ever use those samples for validation or testing, because those samples are artificially generated samples. So let's come back to the hyperparameter tuning bit. I generate weights or ratios in the range of 0.05 to 0.25. There is something called as make_pipeline, which helps you create a pipeline in SMOTE. So you can start off with SMOTE specifying what all modules you would require to create a pipeline. So I would require SMOTE and then a logistic regression module.
I create a grid search CV object and save it into a variable called as GSC, and I do a threefold cross validation. The scoring method that I'm kind of targeting right now is my F1 score. Let's see what the results are. This process will take some time. Now, using hyperparameter tuning, I am able to find out that the best SMOTE ratio is 0.05, which is evident from the graph as well. So now I'll be using that same value of 0.005 and making a logistic regression module, fitting it to my training data again, and then validating it. So now when I find out the confusion matrix, now there is a perfect balance between false positives and false negatives. Now when I generate the model report, it's a highly accurate model as expected, and the AUC ROC values are also very high. So this was my take on how you can use SMOTE effectively for oversampling your data. If you do have any questions with what we've covered in this video, then please feel free to ask in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer those. If you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then the easiest way is to simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also it's a huge help to share these videos with anyone whom you think would find them useful. Be sure to subscribe for future videos and thank you so much for watching.